Self-control is a part of growth. James chapter 3 verse 2. For we all stumble in many things. If anyone does not stumble in word, he is a perfect man, able also to bridle the whole body. A perfect man is a man who has grown up in God, who no longer is a child, but he is the heir, and he's grown up now to inherit the promises of God. Now, who is this perfect man? We see here that this is someone who has integrity in the word. The word as in the words that are spoken, they're keeping their word. You know, they have integrity in that. And if they don't stumble in the word and the bridling of their tongue, then we know that they are mature. And there's the second aspect to this. It says that when we're able to control our tongue, we are also in a better position to control our entire body. Why control our tongue and the whole of our body? Because the flesh is crucified because of what Jesus has done on the cross for us. And so we've got to walk in that victory, and we have to overcome the flesh. And many times that begins by the control of our tongue and the other lusts that the body is given to. And we see here that maturity has to do with controlling our words, the words that come out of our mouths. The senses, our senses, how we're able to control those senses in order to live a godly life before God. I'm going to read for us another scripture, Hebrews 5 and verse 14. It says, but solid food belongs to those who are of full age, that is, those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. So not only is maturity to do with the control of the body or the control of the flesh, but also the exercise of our senses to discern good from evil. And all of this comes with practice. We've got to keep trusting God. We've got to keep moving from one step to the next and one level to the next. And that's how we're going to mature in God. And, you know, one thing is that God is glorified when His people grow up in Him. Psalm 92 in verse 12, it says, the righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. He shall grow like a cedar in Lebanon. So growth is somehow compared with flourishing here, the flourishing of a palm tree. And God wants that for each of us. We talked about the fact that spiritual growth is important, and spiritual growth means growing up in the Word, growing up in our relationships with others, growing up in this godly disciplines, a godly lifestyle, and of course, in the control of our flesh. So shall we look to God right now and ask Him to make this journey of growth? Heavenly Father, we thank You that each of us, oh God, can come to the full potential that You have for us. Yes, Lord, we ask for the fullness of the Godhead, Lord Jesus, to be manifest in us. And God, we pray that, Lord, we will not stop, but we'll keep increasing in You, O God, because You are the God of the increase, Lord. And thank You, Lord. Thank You that, Lord, You're giving each of us that desire, Lord, to come up higher in You. And I pray, God, I pray that the Holy Spirit will, Lord, do a great and a deep work in our hearts. So God, Father, we thank You once again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.